Great. Okay. So yeah, my name is Jacob, and today I'm going to present you some results where we have worked on a mixed integer nonlinear programming scheduling problem for a district heating production site, where we basically have implemented a new initialization approach. Okay, so what is the motivation behind solving this type of problem? Well, as engineers and researchers, we are often faced with a trade-off when we are modeling between model complexity and the accuracy of our models. And generally, the higher complexity of our model, the higher accuracy. However, if we're going to optimize our models, it gets quite fast, very hard to optimize very complex models. And therefore, there is currently a tendency to prefer a lower accuracy model, which is easier to optimize. And therefore, if we're able to develop better methods for dealing with typically non-convex optimization problems, then we have more freedom when we are modeling our systems. Okay, so now on to the model that we have, our test model for our initialization procedure. It's a basic district heating model. We have a combined heat and power plant producing some heat. Supplied to the district heating transmission network, and it's also producing some electricity, which is supplied to the grid. Overall, it's expressed in terms of mass and temperatures, mass flows and temperatures in the system, and it has a thermal storage, as you can see over here, where the energy contained is defined also in terms of mass and temperature. Then we have included different heat losses in the system. We have a storage heat loss, a forward transmission heat loss, and a return transmission heat loss. Then we have the demand node down here, which is basically an aggregated node for all the distribution network. We end up with 19 equations, 24 variables per time step, which gives us five decisions in total, or five additional decision variables per time step that we are implementing this model. The relationship between the heat and electricity production is modeled with this piecewise linear function, as we see here, where the production mode is controlled with a binary variable we call C. I won't go into further detail with the modeling. You can refer to the paper for seeing the full mathematical formulation. So overall, the objective function of this optimization problem is consisting of some fuel costs and some electricity or some monetary gains from selling electricity to the grid, where we also pay for buying electricity to our pump driving the transmission mass flow. And the fuel is of course dependent on the electricity production and the heat production. The overall cost is then given as the sum of the hourly cost across all the hours that we are scheduling. And this is a non-convex mixed integer nonlinear program. This means that the quality of the solutions we get to this optimization problem is very dependent on how we initialize our solvers. And this means that we have implemented this optimization framework where we use a sliding window approach. This is very inspired from the way you solve or the method you use in model predictive control, where you have a given horizon And then you solve, you optimize for this given horizon, and then you implement a part of the solution that you obtain. And this is the same method we use for our framework. So the thing here is that that what we change, we basically have three different configurations for this framework. First configuration is the new initialization method that we have developed, this Monte Carlo Tree Search, and combined with a nonlinear standard local nonlinear problem solver that we use to solve our sub-optimization problem. The second configuration is the same initialization method, but combined with a branch and bound solver, more you can call it a global solver. And the final one is is a random initialization procedure often used when dealing with non-convex problems, and again the branch and bound solver. Okay, so on to the Monte Carlo Tree Search initialization procedure. Well, when we have a search tree, we need a set of finite amount of actions we can choose between when we navigate the search tree. And we basically obtain this for our optimization problem by discretizing our variables into some given amount. And then an action, in our case, is then given as a choice of values for our five decision variables that we have in this specific optimization problem. And this could be, for example, a temperature of 60 degrees on our forward transmission flow. It could be a mass flow of 3 tons per second in our forward flow, and it could be a mass flow of 1 ton per second going into or out to the storage. And it could be one or zero here for the binary variable, telling us if we are loading or uncharging the storage. And the last one here is also zero or one, expresses whether which of the two production lines we are running on, as I showed you earlier. Okay, so how do we use these discretizations in our tree search? So I'm not going to explain you the full detail of this algorithm, but I'm going to give you an intuitive sense of how it works. So each node stores two values in memory, a value called Q. This is basically representing the cost function, or the expected cost of taking an action given a state. And then it contains the number n, which is basically the visit count. This is incremented by one each time we pass through a node. So looking at the given example here, if we start at the root node, we of course want to minimize the cost. So we choose the 0.5 node here. Then we see that we haven't expanded any of the child nodes yet. So we choose a random one. We evaluate if it's feasible or not, and evaluate the cost function. If it's feasible, then we backpropagate the cost function value such that we obtain a new lower bound when we get to the root node. Next time, we can then see that now it's no longer this action that is the best to choose, but rather the other one. And again, we get to a node which hasn't been where any of the child nodes hadn't been expanded. So we make the same procedure and arrive at the root node again. And this way, we can balance exploration and exploitation, which means that we can expand our search tree in an asymmetric way, depending on this exploration bias and the expected cost that we get when we arrive at a new node. Okay, so onto the experimental setup. As I talked about, we have three different frameworks And in order to test these, we have chosen a scheduling period of 48 hours. You can see down here, we have a heating demand of 48 hours. And over here, we have a electricity price of 48 hours. And here you can see the best solutions found for each of the three configurations, which were run a given number of times. And as you can see, the three methods looks quite alike. However, there are some differences. And we can see over here when the electricity price gets very high that all the three configurations favors to basically put a lot of energy into the storage because it's very profitable to produce a lot of electricity in these hours. Okay, so basically we have run these three configurations for a number of horizon lengths from 5 to 14. And for each horizon length, we have run each configuration for 5 times because it's a non-convex problem. We get different solutions each time we run these simulations. And as we can see, the longer horizon we have, the lower cost we also get, which is of course expected. The more fluctuations in electricity the algorithm can take into account. But the longer the is also the simulation time. Interestingly, we can see that the branch and bound solver outperforms the nonlinear problem solver. This is also expected. And that the two branch and bound or the initialization method doesn't really matter for lower horizon lengths. However, when we get to very large problem sizes, it starts to make a difference, as you can also see down depicted on this box plot, where we can see that the Monte Carlo initialization provides much better consistency than the random initialization. So to conclude, we tested a new initialization method against the random initialization for this test problem, the district heating system. And we found that that the Monte Carlo Tree Search initialization actually provided better consistency and better solutions for larger window sizes in this problem. And just to give you a metric of what this means, if you use the medians from the previous slide, you can get around a saving of 2 million Danish crowns per year for the case system if you use the Monte Carlo Tree Search initialization compared to the random initialization. And that was it from my side.